Now I'm going to explain in more detail about the cost structure. So as I mentioned before, so these are the four parts of the cost. And for every part of the cost, most of the knowledge and content will be delivered either face-to-face or by using e-learning tools. Then after that, you have the activity and assessment to help you to acquire the knowledge in more firmly. So for the lab technique, you will have a lot of the lab session, okay, allow you to hands-on. And after that, the other three part is mostly there will be a lot of the tutorial activity. Okay, some of the tutorial you will get the mark, some of the tutorial activities you will not get the marks. Okay, the idea of the tutorial or activity or any assessment is to help you to learn the subject, the topic. So in the course material, you will find this table. So actually this is show how much time you need to spend, okay, in lecture, activity, and in the assessment, of course in the final and midterm. And also how much time that you need to spend, you will see me face to face. Okay, the face to face is that it's not really the physically face-to-face, but somehow if you watch my video, it's considered face-to-face as well. And also the time that you have to spend to study. So this is the estimate time that you have to spend to master the topic. Okay. And you also have an activity. So this is the time that you need to spend. So mostly these are the lab. Okay. And you also need to prepare and do some reading before and after the activity. Okay. And for the assessment, so those are the hours you have to spend. So this is each of these is hours, how many hours you need to spend to complete the activity and the assessment. Okay. So for some activity you have to do some preparation. And this is a midterm and final. Okay. And you also have time for you to prepare final and also to prepare your midterm. So altogether in this semester you need to spend 120 hours because this is a 3 credit hour subject. So you need to spend 120 hours. So if I divide the number of the hours according to the topic that you learn, so you can see most of the time that you spend in this to learn of the lab technique. After that you're going to spend considerable amount of time to learn the skill and also the tools, okay, to do the data analysis. And then for the rest, you have to, the other part of the course, you have to learn a little bit about the theory and also the application. Okay. So starting from week 2, you're going to learn the DNA preservation and extraction. You might have done some extraction in the cell biology and the cell biology and genetic course, but in this course you're going to have more practical. You also will learn again the PCR. So you can find this information in your course material. So every week there's a topic that you have to learn, and instead of just give you the topic, I also specify what you have to know, okay, to what level of your understanding, your knowledge about the topic that you have to acquire. For example, for DNA preservation, you have to know the procedure, okay, how to collect the biological sample for DNA study. Okay. Then the second learning outcome for DNA preservation is you should not only to know the principle, but you have to understand the principle and the method of DNA preservation. Okay. So make sure you go through this every week, okay, before the lectures. It's even better if you can study first before come to the class. Okay. Then you have the gel electrophoresis. So you have learned this already, I guess. In any case, we will learn this again. Okay. And in week 14, you're also going to learn the next generation sequencing. But for this one, we don't have the lab session because there are too many of you and we don't have the instrument here in ITBC, although we have the instrument in UMS, but it's not feasible to have a lab session for this one. In any case, you will learn a little bit of the concept and theory. At least you know what is this. Okay, what is the difference between next generation sequencing and the the Sanger sequencing, okay, the traditional sequencing. Then the second part of the lecture is more on the theory. So you need to know different type of genetic marker. So which part of the genome, the sequence you have to study for fungi, microbial, plant, animal. Okay? Because different organisms, they have different cell type, different organelle. So you can study the DNA at different organelle, depend on the cells, and also your research questions. You also have to learn about DNA barcoding, the concept of the DNA barcoding. Then after that, the third part, okay, after the 7 week, half of the lecture, half of the course, you're going to learn quite a number of the tools and analysis by using software. Okay, so there are many things you have to learn. Okay, so that's the reason why you have so many tutorials. If you just listen to the lecture, you will not remember, and also you will not know how to apply and do the analysis after you complete the course. Then the last part of the lecture is more on the application. So we will discuss a lot of the case study, okay, using the biological tools, okay, and data analysis to study the genetic of the organism and try to solve the conservation and biodiversity issue. So you need to read a lot of the paper, okay, to see a lot of the example, how different tools is used to solve different problems. So that in the future, when you read the article, you can understand what it's talking about. Okay, especially those conservation biology article, they use the molecular tool in their study. So to summarize, at the end of the course, not this lecture, at the end of the course, you should have the adequate comprehension and also the skill for experiment design, okay, how to design a study. So first, you have a research question, you have the problem, you have an issue related to conservation. And if those problems related to genetic, then you have to know, you should already know which technique, which tools you have to use, okay, which part of the genome you have to study, okay, then get the sequence. After you get the sequence, you should also know how to do the data analysis according to your objective and research questions, and then know how to apply it to solve the biodiversity and conservation problem. So take your time, this is a long course. Make sure you follow the lectures, and if necessary, do some extra reading. And the most important thing is make sure you follow all the tutorial and assignment.